the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Doucette is on the field to kick this one off, and everyone in the stadium is ready for this game to get started. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Kirk, one of the top backs in the country we get a chance to see today. Ridgeway's big play ability makes him a threat to score really anytime he touches.
I love this guy. And let's not forget about his big offensive line. This is a group that really prides themselves in opening up some huge holes for him. It's also going to be difficult to stop him and keep him out of the end zone because, you think about it, he's known for his big plays, the home run ability. So if you can limit those big plays, you got a shot at least at slowing him down.
And he gets the ball 25, 30 times a game, and he'll probably get that again today. From their own 40-yard line, first down. Throws into coverage, just picked off. He's at the 40. He's tackled around the 34-yard line. Not a good decision there. Why'd he even throw that pass?
Well, this is a good job by the corner of sitting back and reading the quarterback's eyes. Good job of disguising coverage as well.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 34. Made at the 26. A nice job by the offensive line, and they pick up a gain of 8.
That makes it second and 2.
And he's tackled at the 8-yard line. Down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. There's a play fake, and he has it on the corner. Decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown. Splits the uprights with the extra point. It was a quick three-play, 34-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Wildcats are right where they want to be early in this one, partner.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
The quarterback threw an interception on their last drive. Let's see if they can be more successful here.
He's got a lot of time to forget about that last pick. He's just got to stick to the game plan. You know, as a running back, you've got to get upfield north and south. That time, he just seemed to wait and kind of delay his reaction and just got to be able to make a read, get upfield as quickly as possible. In college football, and especially up in the NFL, the more you're dancing around waiting for a big play, the more time you're giving an athletic defense a chance to come and make a play in the backfield against you. And that's what happened.
Fires quickly, and he's got his man. And down he goes at the 38. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
From their own 38-yard line, first down. The Eagles running back, he was injured earlier. You see him down there on the sideline, and it looks like he's ready to get back in the game. Pruitt picks up 2 yards with a carry.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That brings up second and 9.
Tight. He's at midfield. He's at the 40. At the 30. And they finally tackle him at the 23. Let's see now how the defense responds to giving up the gain on the run. They try running left. Nice run there as they work the outside.
That'll make it second and four.
Out here. They'll bring him down at the 7.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
First and goal, and a touchdown ties it, folks. Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receivers.
This wide receiver is very frustrated. You can tell by his body language. He did everything he needed to do to get open to be able to make a big play. The quarterback just didn't put the ball in the money.
Here's the handoff, and he's taken down for a loss. A loss on that one as he couldn't get past those big linemen.
You got that right. They sacrificed their bodies in there and stuffed it.
Third and goal. Ball on the 11-yard line. Strike to his receiver, no good.
I know that this quarterback and wide receiver were very confident they'd be able to execute this play. They worked all week long in practice on this play. The problem is the wide receiver got too close to the boundary, just didn't give himself or the quarterback's throw much of a chance to make the reception.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
After review, they decided that the call on the field will stand. Kick is up, and he's got it.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding him to a field goal right there.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. A touchdown was the result of their last drive, and a good chunk of those yards were gained by way of the rushing attack. Taken down at the 26-yard line. It's second and 9. Ball on the 26-yard line. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. He's to the 40. He makes the catch and has a first down. Brought down at the 44. First and 10. Ball on the 44. On the handoff, big hit, and he'll lose yardage.
That's a loss of 1 yard. That makes it second and 10.
He's scrambling, and he's going to be sacked for a loss. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 46. A quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Incomplete. A little juice on that one.
And this quarterback sometimes gets a little bit too excited back there and tries to put too much on it. He's got to relax and just make a good throw.
Burns to punt. Brought down at the 27-yard line. The Wildcats really came prepared to play defense today, and the plan is working.
Well, so far in this game, you've got to tip your cap to the defensive coordinator. He has clearly done a very good job of getting his team ready to play, and they have done a nice job of slowing down this very explosive offense.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Tackle at the 28.
That's good for a game of 1 yard. That makes it second and eight.
Credit those two defenses in that first quarter, or blame the offenses for a lack of production. 7-3, Wildcats. And we welcome you back to the action here, and we have got a tight one going on in quarter number two. From their own 28-yard line. Third down. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. He's at midfield. And they finally push him out at the 44-yard line. First and 10, ball on the 44-yard line. Runs it right, nice pickup.
That brings him second and five.
Can't blame him for not hanging on to that pass. He got hit pretty hard.
And they'll look to convert here on another third down. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And he's taken down around the 32-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
The stop at the 23-yard line.
That brings up second and one.
Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. Quick pass. He's tackled at about the 17-yard line. Hudson gained 6 yards on the play, and they'll come away with a first down.
Short throws like this are very effective because they tend to wear down the defense over the course of a game, especially when they get you a first down and keep the offense on the field.
And I think it throws it into coverage, and it's intercepted.
This quarterback better start making better decisions in the passing game. Otherwise, this corner will come up with even more picks in the future.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 10. Tillman takes the give. Gets to about the 11-yard line.
That makes it second and eight.
They come out on an empty backfield. throws, and that one's going to hit the ground incomplete. Third and eight. Ball on their own 11. He lets it fly. What a tackle. That was going to be a touchdown. So let's see how the defense responds now. It's first down and 10. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. The 10. And he will score. Once this halfback got past the second level, there was nobody that was going to stop him.
This offense has so many dangerous weapons in the option attack, it's almost impossible to slow him down.
And he converts the extra point. A four-play, 91-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. Doucette has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Offense comes back out looking to improve from their last effort.
The game is in danger of getting out of hand early. It's very, very important that they not only hang on to the football this drive, but they also need to get a score on the board as well.
Handoff, and he's met in the backfield. Nowhere to go for the halfback. That's a loss of one.
That'll bring up second and 11.
We've got a second and 11. Ball on the 24. Caught out in the open. Tackle made at the 38-yard line. The middle. He fights forward to about the 39. The Eagles taking their first time out of the half. 2 minutes left in the half. Close to 9-yard pickup there on the sling. So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. And that'll give them another first down.
Excellent job there, Brad, of running the football. That was good execution by this offense.
Incomplete.
That would have been pretty remarkable if he'd managed to hold on to the ball after taking a shot like that.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 44. He's on the run. Now he's going to run and watch out. And he's tackled at the 37-yard line.
That'll bring up third and four.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Fires quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. A minute left in the half. And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. It's up.
Last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air.
You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
Fires out to his receiver, and down he goes at the 46-yard line. They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense, and in this case, he did. Nice job.
Throws in the middle. They'll bring him down at the 48-yard line. First down there on a 2-yard pass.
Nice play there to move the chains and keep the drive rolling.
The defense has got some of their best pass defenders on the field. They set up in the dime to counter that 5-wide receiver set. He's taken down at the 49-yard line.
That'll make it second and 7.
He scrambles. They bring him down.
That makes it third and 7.
Caught with room to work. Brought down at the 36-yard line. And they're going to put 6 DBs on the field to counter that 5-receiver look. Tackle at the 25-yard line. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. 5 wide receivers. Now he's scrambling. And he's taken down at about the 15-yard line. So we've played 2 quarters. The Wildcats lead 14-3.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half.
Power, iso, counter, sweeps, run. And look at that defensive line on skates. An impressive performance running the football in the first half.
I love grown man football. Nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. You don't have to do all this fancy stuff and throw all the yard and pass and run with your quarterback all the time. We're lining up. We're hitting you right in the eyes. If you want to do something about it, put your big boy pads on, come forward and hit me and stop me.
Just about time to start the second half. What do you think Herb Street's first point of analysis will be?
I don't know, something to do with quarterback play, I'm sure. I mean, always got to hear that stuff all the time. It's all about the quarterbacks.
Brad and Kirk ready for the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Scrambling around. And they make the stop at about the 33-yard line. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Flares it, and almost had it intercepted.
This just shows you that you don't need to be sacking the quarterback to disrupt the passing game.
Away from one, and now he's got the corner. He gets out to about the 35-yard line.
Just a good showing on all 3 downs by the defense. That should fire him up.
Pruitt is back to receive.
Well, the coverage team did their job and made the play. Let's see if the defense can continue the effort.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Gets to about the 27-yard line. Ridgeway gains about 2 yards on the run.
That makes it second and 8.
From their own 27-yard line, It's second down. He's out of bounds, right around the 28-yard line. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. And he throws it away.
Let's see if the momentum from that defensive stand carries over to their offense.
Mayo is waiting for the snap. Kelly fields it at the 30. He's taken down at the 40. Let's see if this drive has a more rewarding conclusion than their last, which ended with a punt. And he hits him hard at midfield. From the 50, it's first down. He's at the 40. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. He's tackled right around the 36-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 33-yard line.
That makes it second and six.
From the 33-yard line, second down. And he makes it out to about the 31-yard line.
That'll make it 35.
You're not ready. You're not ready. 47.
They come out in a five-wide set. He's going to try and scramble. Tackle made at the 26-yard line. From the 26-yard line, first down. Fights forward to about the 23.
That makes it 76.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That'll make it third and one.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one.
Job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
He's scrambling. And he's tackled right around the 10-yard line. Here's play number 10 on the drive. Fakes to the back. And down he goes at about the 3-yard line. Second down and goal. 3 yards for the touchdown. And the goal line defense digging in here. And he tackles him hard at the 1. We're at the 12th play of the drive. He's in for the touchdown.
There are some guys, when they get near the goal line, they just have a knack for getting the ball into the end zone. That's what we saw right there.
He hits the PAT. So a 12-play, 61-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. They can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Wildcats continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Up the middle for a nice gain. He makes his way to about the 48. One more quarter to play. 21-3, Wildcats. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. Throws this one away. It's third down, and they're about the length of the football away from the first down marker. We're still early in the fourth quarter, but that was a huge stop, and now with the lead, they're going to get the football back and an opportunity to stretch the lead. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. He makes his way to about the 38. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Him out at the 35-yard line, and that'll be a first down on the 3-yard pass.
Since he only needed a few yards, the little dump off pass worked to perfection.
So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. They'll bring him down at the 22-yard line. We've got a first and 10, ball on the 22. It out to maybe the 19-yard line. That'll make it 77. And he makes it out to about the 17-yard line. It's third down and 6 to go. Ball on the 17-yard line. Tries to buy some time. The 10, loose football. The defense scoops it. That's a big break. for this defense.
You know, this offense just can't afford to be getting hit with the turnover bug. They need to hold on to the football.
So they're just about set to get the game going again.
Roger, Roger.
Just under three to go in regulation. Fires out quickly to the tailback, and he is drilled at the 35.
Number 10 on the tackle at the 35-yard line. That'll make it
second and seven. Ball on the 35-yard line. Throws complete, and he stopped immediately. The first down catch. Good open field tackle. Gets it out to his receiver and he can't hang on. It's second and 10. Ball on the 50. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Quick out to his receiver. And he's leveled at the 37. And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five receiver look. Throws complete. He's got room to work. He's taken down at the 24. Quick throw, and he's got his receiver again.
Call it a gain of 4 yards. That brings him second and five.
Here's the eighth play of the series. They're in the red zone, so this quarterback better be smart. Last time he threw a pick down here. Carries the ball for a nice game. A little over a minute in the game. Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds. First and goal from the two, and they can smell the end zone. They come out on an empty backfield. Looks to the end zone and it's caught. Touchdown. So they go to the air and they come away with six, Kirk.
Man, Brad, I got to tell you, that's not an easy thing to do there. The defenses nowadays are so tough when you get inside the red zone.
So the offense will stay on the field and attempt the two-point conversion. They'll bring him down at the 43. A fumble ended this offense's last drive. Let's see as they come out on the field what they'll do this time around.
Sometimes when you lose the football, you start to focus a little bit more. So a turnover can actually work out in your favor.
The Eagles will use their first time out of the half. From the 44-yard line, second down. Brought down around the 41-yard line. And the halfback carries for a pickup of three. The Eagles call a timeout. That's their second of the half. Around the 32-yard line. Nice game for the halfback.
That time they kept it on the ground with the counter play. The blocking was great up front, and the tailback was able to get into the open field and do some special things.
And the quarterback's going to take a knee to drain this clock and any hopes the opposition may have had. From the 35-yard line, second down. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. Favorite play in football of your quarterback. Take a knee. One's all but wrapped up with the final score, the Wildcats 21, the Eagles 11. And the Eagles. Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.